vibe right now, feel myself.
Panda.
Panda.
Panda, 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 panda.
Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another video. Today I am doing a 3D panda for the very first time and I wanted to show you guys how I achieved this look. So I was scrolling down Instagram and I came across Haha Nails' picture of the set that she did, and I will leave a picture so you guys can see it. And I thought the set was so cool that I just had to try it for myself. So this is the video of me attempting to do a 3D panda. So I'm using my practice hand, and as normal I am prepping the nail and I am applying my tip and I'm cutting the tip to the desired length, and I'm gonna do this nail coffin. So I'm just going to snip off the sides and then I'm going to file the shape to perfect it. So I'm going to lay a thin layer of clear acrylic and I'm going to cover this nail with gold flakes, and that is going to be my main color for this nail. And then I'm going to encapsulate this nail with clear once again, and I'm making sure to work with thin layers because I do not want this nail to be thick. So I'm just placing the gold flakes on the nail and then I'm going to encapsulate this before I add my design. And I am also using my Alpha number 10 Oval Kalinske brush, and if you would like to purchase one for yourself, the link will be down below in the description along with my discount code so you can get a brush for yourself. And I am now going in with my Mia Secret Clear and I'm going to encapsulate this nail, making sure to work with thin layers so the nail is not super thick. I am now going in with Chris Trio's 100-180 grit file, and I'm going to perfect the shape before I file the nail surface. I am now going in with my safety carbide bit by McCart, and I'm going to smooth the nail surface and make sure there are no imperfections on the nail before I buff and apply my 3D design. So once the nail has been filed and buffed, I am now going in with a small bead of black, and this is going to be the body of the panda, and I'm just going to apply a very thin layer and I'm going to blend this towards the tip so it's not a super thick 3D design. So I'm just going to blend this black towards the tip and then I'll be applying the head. Thank you. So once I have laid the body of the panda, I am going to pick up a small bead of white and I'm going to place this right on top of the body. And I'm just going to shape this out so that it matches a head-like shape of a panda. So once I have sculpted the 3D head, I am making little pockets of where the eyes will be, and I'm going to fill these pockets with black acrylic. So I am now going in with my black and I am going to sculpt the eyes of the panda. So now I will be picking up two beads of white, one being bigger than the other, and I'm going to place these beads where the nose of the panda will be, and I'm going to sculpt this into the nose of the panda. So I am now picking up a smaller bead of white, and this is going to be the nose of the panda. So with a really small bead of black, I am going in and I am creating the mouth of the panda. I will also be using the black to sculpt a heart-like shape to create the nose. I am now going to pick up two small beads and I'm going to place them at the top of the head to create the ears of the panda. Now using Zule's nail glue to attach this little chain link that I had in my drawer, and this is going to be the chain for the panda. In the photo it was gold, but we will have to settle for silver. I will now be going in with this really pretty pink that I have, and I'm going to create 3D flowers. Once I have created the 3D flowers, I will be applying the top coat, and I will only be applying the top coat around the panda. I do not want this on top of the face of the panda because it will not give it the 3D effect that we are looking for. And then I will be curing this in my LED lamp for 60 seconds. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and this tutorial. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button as well as the notification bell so you can be notified every time I post a new video. Once again, thank you for watching the video, and I'll see you on the next video.